So I think there is a top five of dinosaurs in the popular imagination, and Stegosaurus is definitely among them. It's probably number three. Of course, T-Rex is number one, Triceratops is number two, that's just my personal favorite, followed closely by Stegosaurus. So Stegosaurus is a stegosaur, and that sounds ridiculous, but stegosaurs in general take their name from Stegosaurus. And they include other dinosaurs that are generally around in the middle and late Jurassic, so up to about 145 million years ago. And we have fossils of stegosaurs from North America, from Europe, Asia, and Africa. And it's possible, in fact, that they were present on all continents during the Jurassic. Other species of stegosaur outside of Stegosaurus include animals like Kentrosaurus or Gigant Spinosaurus. But even among stegosaurs, Stegosaurus is different to most other species because instead of having just spines along its back, it has these distinctive plates. People surprisingly often ask me who would have won in a fight between Stegosaurus and T-Rex, but they lived 80 million years apart from each other, and in fact they never would have met, sadly. So we'll never find out. Because Stegosaurus lived 150 million years ago, and T-Rex lived around 70 million years ago, we're actually much closer in time to Tyrannosaurus Rex than Stegosaurus was. So Stegosaurus was extinct long before the extinction of dinosaurs, 66 million years ago. For a long time, the backplates of Stegosaurus were thought to be used in defense. But actually, Stegosaurus evolved from other stegosaurs that have spikes along their back. It's very unlikely that those spikes evolved into plates specifically for defense. Also, the plates are actually rather loosely attached to the back, and it's not clear that they could have resisted the strong forces of a predator coming down on them in some way. People have also suggested that the backplates of Stegosaurus might be used in regulating its body temperature. We know they had a rich blood supply because they have traces of nerves and blood vessels along them. That might have allowed Stegosaurus to heat its blood or cool its blood and therefore regulate its body temperature. Actually, the most likely function of the plates in Stegosaurus is that it was used somehow in displays to other individuals of Stegosaurus, so either in mating displays or in displays of dominance, similar to the extravagant feathery displays of some birds today, and similar to the colors, frills, and sails of some lizards living today. The spikes of other stegosaurs might have been used to some extent in displays to other individuals within the same species, but they also could have had a defensive function because spikes are spiky and, you know, that might help in defense. So Stegosaurus has four spikes on the end of its tail, and you may have heard that this is called the thagomyza. Now, I'm sorry to let you down, but that's not the official science name for it. We just call them the tail spikes. But they probably weren't used to attack other dinosaurs. They were probably used for defense against other dinosaurs. Stegosaurs probably didn't travel in herds. When we find their fossils, they're often single individuals, and sometimes they're associated with other dinosaurs, like big sauropod dinosaurs. So it's likely that they aggregated with other herbivores, but it might have been rare for them to form Stegosaurus-specific herds. People often say that Stegosaurus had a really tiny brain, and that's true. The brain of Stegosaurus was about the size of a small lemon or lime. Stegosaurus would not have been very smart. But the head of Stegosaurus was also extremely small. So when people compare the size of Stegosaurus's brain to its enormous 5-ton body, then the brain seems super small. In the context of the small skull of Stegosaurus, then the brain is pretty small, but not exceptionally smaller than other reptiles. People also often say that Stegosaurus had an extra brain just at the base of its tail in its pelvis. Now, that's not quite true. There is an enlargement of the space available for the nerve cord, but that's not actually a brain. That's just a large bundle of nerves that's quite common among other animals. We don't know what Stegosaurus's eggs looked like. We've never found any fossils of them. We do have some very small juvenile Stegosauruses, maybe 1 meter in length, but the actual hatchlings would have been much smaller than that. Stegosaurus did not have feathers, but it's not entirely clear that it didn't have any form of feather-like structures. The skin of Stegosaurus basically would have appeared scaly, somewhat similar to a croc or a lizard today. It would be really difficult for us to tell if they had just a few fibers on their body, similar to the hair of an elephant, for example. We have no direct evidence of what color Stegosaurus would have been. Since we believe the most likely function of the plates was in display, it's possible that they had interesting colors. We have no idea what those colors might have been, though. Stegosaurus ate plants. It was a herbivorous dinosaur. Even the group that stegosaurs belong to, the ornithischian dinosaurs, were almost entirely herbivorous. Plants at that time were slightly different to plants today, but include many living groups, things like ginkgos, cycads, and ferns. Stegosaurus had teeth in the back of its jaw, but a beak in the front of its jaw. They're somewhat similar to the teeth of a green iguana today. So we currently have no idea how long an individual Stegosaurus might have lived. We have a very limited amount of data on the life history. One of the exciting things we're going to do in the museum is we have permission to cut a sample of the thigh bone of Apex, a particularly large, mature individual of Stegosaurus, in order to study the microstructure of the bone, including potential growth rings, a bit like tree rings, that are going to tell us about how old the specimen might have been, and also contribute to our understanding of growth and life history of Stegosaurus in general by comparing two samples from other individuals.